Over there.
Are you going to tell me what this is all about?
You're being held hostage. We'll set you free when they let Andrea Hennessey go.
Don't be ridiculous. They'll never agree.
Shut up! Just do as you're told and you won't get hurt, all right? Have a look in her wardrobe. Get a coat or something to put over this shotgun when we go out.
Right. Hennessey is serving a sentence for 3 months. Have you any idea how long you'll get for kidnapping?
We're not kidnapping. We're holding you hostage.
You'll have trouble explaining the difference to the courts.
We don't have to explain anything to them. Anyway, we've got nothing to lose. They're already after us for trying to get Andrea out.
Oh, that was you, was it? I might have guessed. That was also very stupid.
Shut up!
Will this do?
Yeah, give it here. We're going out to our van. And just remember, I've got this pointing at you.
Oh, shouldn't we blindfold her or something?
Yeah. We'd look pretty stupid walking out in the street like that, wouldn't we?
Yeah, sorry, I didn't think.
You make one false move and I'll shoot. Get the door. Move!
Here we go, mate. You all right?
Yeah.
She's getting worse, Dor. I wish we had him at home.
What could we do for him there?
Oh, at least he's got an atomizer there.
What?
Oh, it's a sort of inhaler, a spray to help him breathe.
Well, we'll go to your house and get it.
Oh, sure, with the cops around. And what if my dad saw me? He'd dob me in straight away.
Yeah, well, we've got to do something.
Yeah. Look, why don't you shoot through? At least that way, if I get caught breaking in, you'll be in the clear.
No. Look. If you go, you're going to have to leave Martin on his own. And there must be some other place we can get one of those atomizer things.
Well, yeah, at chemist.
Well, then?
You need a prescription.
Look, I told you you wouldn't be very good on the run without me. Look, you can get things out of chemists without prescriptions all the time. I used to do it. Got any money?
Yeah, that's it.
That'll do. I'll be back soon.
Well, Doreen...
I'll be all right.
Just moves. Blow her head off.
You don't want to shoot me.
Shut up. You heard what Linda said.
Oh, is that her name?
Shut up!
Yeah, I'd like to speak to the head of the department. If that's his name. Well, just get him out of the meeting. Look. We've just kidnapped one of your jailers, Erica Davidson. Do you think that will get him to the phone? Yeah, I thought it would.
Where are you taking me?
Don't be stupid. Why do you think we blindfolded you?
It shouldn't be too hard to work out. We've been travelling for about an hour. I can hear the water.
I'd say it. Shut up!
You're not in your prison now, Governor. While you're with us, you'll do as you're told. Come on, out! Come on! You've reached the door, there's a step. Move! Sit down. You can take the blindfold off now. That's right. Take a good look around, because you're going to be here for quite some time.
What's it like being a prisoner instead of a jailer for a change?
You'll find out soon enough.
They'll never catch us. Once they let Andrea go, we'll just shoot through.
They'll never let her go.
No? Well, you better hope that they do. Otherwise, you're dead. Either way, we're in the clear. How can they catch us? You don't know where you are, and you don't even know our names.
Do you want me to make some coffee?
Yeah. Might as well make ourselves at home.
How long do you reckon it'll be before we get an answer from the department?
Well, I gave them a couple of hours. They'll have to check out that we're telling the truth first. Probably run at her place now, searching for her.
I don't think you'll have time for coffee.
That gun's a fake. But this isn't.
Shall we give her a cup?
No. She's going to find it too hard drinking with her hands tied.
Fletcher. No, I'm afraid Mrs. Davidson's not here at the moment. Well, we're very short-staffed. She did a double shift and then she went home to get some sleep. Well, she's probably got the phone off the hook. I've no idea. Well, yes, I will, but I doubt if she'll be in again today. Or is there anything I can do? Come in.
A deputation from the women want to talk to you.
Look, just hang fire for a minute, will you? The department wants to contact Mrs. Davidson urgently. I'm just trying to get hold of her now.
Okay.
It's funny, she's not answering. Well, what's all this about a deputation?
Oh, well, it's just Smith and Birdsworth. They'd like to talk to you about the attendance centre.
But what about it?
Well, they'd just like the scheme to continue.
No, I'm afraid that's out of the question. Look, I haven't got time to talk to them now. No, the attendance centre scheme has well and truly had it since Burns escaped.
Oh. Very well.
Can I help you?
Oh, yeah. I need an atomizer for me brother. He's got asthma.
I'm afraid you'll need a prescription.
Oh, I've got a prescription, but I left it at home.
Couldn't you go and get it?
Well, I live a long way away, and by the time I got home and got back here again, well, he could be dead. Well, he's wheezing real bad, and he's only a little kid.
Well, what medication does he take?
I don't know. But he's got one of those inhaler things.
Pretty sure I know what it is. What's your name?
Doreen. Doreen Martin.
Address?
What do you want to know that for?
Well, if you give me your name and address, I'll give you the atomizer now and you can bring in the prescription later. We're not supposed to do it, but since it's an emergency. Anyway, it's not an addictive drug.
Oh. Well, it's 27 Smith Street, Broadwater. Your brother's name's Peter.
Right.
I speak to Mr. Douglas, please. Well, do you know where he is? Which prison? I see. Well, if you do happen to find him, could you tell him that Mr. Fletcher wants to contact him urgently, please? Thank you. Yes. Well, what is it now?
Oh, I was just wondering if you'd finished the new rosters yet.
No, I haven't. Been on the phone for the last half hour or so.
You still looking for Mrs. Davidson?
Yeah, I even phoned the police. You know what they said? They said the department had already reported her missing. Now, why would they report her missing? They've only been looking for her for the last hour or so.
Why didn't you ask them?
Already have. They gave me the runaround. I can't even get hold of Douglas. They reckon they don't know where he is. Yes. Izzy, thank you. Well, that's one mystery solved. Douglas has just driven through the front gate. Go to reception, bring him here to me, will you?
Right.
We'll soon find out what this is all about.
Doreen's here, mate. Come on. It's all right. Just hold on a second. You'll be okay. Did you get her?
Well, no. I almost conned the assistant out of it, and then she turned around to phone up to check on the address I'd given her, and I had to make a run for it.
What are we going to do now?
Well, we could go to your house and break in and get his own medicine. I'll go if you just tell me where it is.
No, look, I'll go. I know what I'm looking for. It's all right. It's too late for that atomizer now. I'm going to have to get him to some emergency treatment. I'll have to take him to the hospital.
What if we get caught?
Well, do you want him to die?
We want the immediate release of Andrea Hennessey and $100,000 in cash.
Doesn't make any sense. She's only got a couple of months left to serve.
Well, I don't think we're dealing with rational minds. They also want amnesty for themselves. All impossible, of course.
How long have you known about this?
Well, they called me about an hour and a half ago.
Well, why wasn't I told? How can I possibly run this place properly if I'm not kept informed? I could have had Hennessey in solitary by now.
That is the last thing we want you to do. Look, the police know how to handle these people. The first rule is not to give the impression that we're victimizing Hennessey in any way. It might provoke the kidnappers.
It's a bit late to worry about provoking them, isn't it?
Well, there is another reason for not putting her into solitary. If we give her no indication that anything is happening, she might get desperate for information. Or make a mistake. Now, I want all your senior staff to keep a very careful eye on her.
All right, what else can we do?
No, nothing. It's a police matter now.
But it's one of our people who's in danger.
I've had strict instructions from the minister. It's to be left totally in the hands of the police. Well, I have to get back to the office. I'm expecting another call from the kidnappers. They'll be expecting an answer to their demands. You may as well walk out with me. We'll talk as we go.
Wendy?
I suppose you want all newspaper, radio and television confiscated.
No need. We've put a media ban on the story.
There's no guarantee a ban like that'll work. The kidnappers might contact the media themselves.
And they, in turn, will have to contact us for confirmation before they make it public. There'll be plenty of time to confiscate radios then. In the meantime, just keep your eyes open and act as if nothing has happened. Now, Mrs. Morris, how are things in your department?
Oh, very interesting.
Good. Pleased to hear somebody's interested in their work. Now, you won't forget what I said, will you, Fletcher?
No, sir.
Good.
Jim, what was that all about?
Eric has been kidnapped by some crackpot mates of Hennessey's. Probably the same mob that tried to spring her out of here the other day.
Oh, that's dreadful. What are they doing about it?
Practically nothing. The minister's made it quite clear that he thinks it's a matter for the police. That way, if anything goes wrong, it's the minister for police who gets the blame, not him. Bloody bureaucrats. They're more interested in saving their own necks than they are in Erica's.
How'd it go? Hopeless. Douglas refused to even talk to me. He said the matter's being handled by the police now. And there's nothing in the paper about it. Well, I don't reckon they're taking us seriously.
No. Well, perhaps we better show them that we mean business and carry out some of our threats. You know, when they kidnapped Paul Getty's grandson, they cut his ear off and sent it with the ransom note. They got their money.
They were also arrested.
If you had an ear missing, perhaps you wouldn't talk as much.
Oh, be serious?
I am being bloody serious. How do you expect anybody to listen if we don't do something drastic?
Well, we could get her to write a letter saying we'll cut her ear off if they don't release Andrea.
That wouldn't work.
No, it wouldn't. To begin with, I wouldn't write the letter.
Oh, you'd write it.
In any case, the department won't give in to your demands. They can't afford to, so you might as well give yourselves up.
Or shoot you now. We're already up for kidnapping. You said so yourself. How's it going to affect us? We may as well be hung for a sheep as a lamb.
They don't hang people anymore. You'd end up with a very long sentence in Wentworth.
We could cut off some of her hair.
What?
We could cut off some of her hair, put it in an envelope and send it to a television station. Well, we're bound to get publicity then.
Yeah, I reckon we would. Get some wrapping paper. We're going to send the TV station a little parcel.
What are we going to do?
Just act natural.
Look, you don't think we should pick another hospital or something?
No, it's too late for that now.
What's the matter with him?
He's got asthma.
Put him on the trolley. Nurse, venti mask.
It's all right, mate. It's okay.
How long has he been like this?
Well, he's been getting worse for hours.
Couldn't you have got some medical treatment earlier?
We lost his prescription.
Okay, now we're going to have to take him in for some emergency treatment. You wait here. Okay.
son?
No, she said wait.
What for? We can't do any more for him now. If we hang around here much longer, that cop is going to recognise us. Come on.
Hold on. We'll need some patient's particulars.
I just parked my car in the ambulance bay. We were just going to go and move it. We'll be right back.
All right.
Wendy, may I have Lizzie Birdsworth's file, please?
Yes, sure thing. She due out soon?
Yes, she is.
I'm Detective Sergeant Ross. I want to see Mr. Fletcher.
Yes, just one moment. There you are, Mrs. Morris.
Thank you.
I'll have to ring and check. Sergeant Ross?
Yes.
My name's Meg Morris. I'm the parole officer here. I was wondering how I'd find out what charges the police would have against someone. He's a friend of one of my parolees. She's very worried about him.
Well, what's his name?
Peter Richards.
Yes, sir, Will.
Never heard of him, but I can check it up for you. Can I reach you here?
Yes, sure.
Mr. Fletcher will see you now.
Oh, I'll take him through, Wendy. You'll just have to sign in first.
Come in.
Detective Sergeant Ross to see you, Jim.
Ah, thanks, Meg. I'm Jim Fletcher. I'm acting governor while Mrs. Davis is missing. What can I do for you?
Well, I'd appreciate any help you can give.
Well, that won't be much. I haven't been told anything.
Well, that's because nobody really knows. Do you mind if I sit down?
Yeah.
It's very disturbing when this sort of thing happens so close to home. We don't expect terrorism in Australia. But then I suppose we're all in potential danger these days.
Well, you wouldn't think so, the way the department's been handling matters.
No, well, they're not in the front line, are they? This Hennessey woman, what's she like?
Political crank. Bit of an extremist, really. She wants freedom for everybody, and she doesn't care who she kills to give it to them.
If I talked to her, do you think she'd say anything?
Well, she was questioned before when they tried to break her out of here. She just clammed up. She won't tell you anything.
Well, then we'll just leave her in the dark. Maybe she'll get desperate for news and try and contact the kidnappers. Has she had any visitors lately?
One or two.
I'd like their names and addresses.
Right.
And if she has any more, let me know and I'll put a tail on them.
Good.
Things must have been pretty hectic for you lately, eh? You've had an escape this week as well, haven't you?
Yes.
Well, it's no good pacing around, you know.
Yeah, I should have stayed at that hospital.
There's nothing you could do for him.
No, there's nothing I can do for anybody. I mean, look, Martin got so worried about me, he got sick. No matter what happens to me, when they catch up to us, you're going to get a longer sentence anyway.
Well, they haven't caught up to us yet.
No, but they will.
Maybe. But I'm not sorry.
No, nor am I.
I suppose if we weren't on the run, well, you wouldn't really want to know me. Me being a prisoner and everything.
Look, if we weren't on the run, we wouldn't have met, would we?
No, I suppose not.
What's it like in prison?
Oh, it's not that bad, once you get used to it, you know. Problem is they tell you what to do all the time, you know, when to eat, when to sleep, when to get up. You're never allowed to think for yourself. Then you get to a point where you can't think for yourself. Forgotten how, you know. Last time I was released, I was back inside in a couple of weeks. I didn't know what else to do. I suppose it'd be tougher in a men's prison. Are you scared of getting caught?
Yeah.
Yes, so am I.
What door?
Hold still and I'll try to cut it straight. There, not too bad.
Here, give me that. Look, that's no bloody good. You could have picked it up off a hairdresser's floor. Hold still or I will cut your ear off.
You'll never get away with this. You'll spend the rest of your lives in jail.
Yeah? Well, you won't be around to see it if we do. That ought to convince them. Although I reckon we should send along a couple of fingers at least. Untie her hands.
No!
Oh, don't worry. We're not going to take your fingers, not yet anyway. You're going to get undressed. Put these on. I've got plans for the clothes you're wearing.
Good
Well, you have finished with it, haven't you?
Yeah.
Want to play cards, B?
No, thank you. I have played enough games of cards at that table to last me the rest of my life. And what are you looking for?
Nothing.
Well, you'll find it in that paper. It's useless.
We could play three-handed poker, B.
Yeah, and you win a few fags from me and I'll win a few fags from you, and what's the point?
Well, you used to play.
That was before I could get out every day and go to the attendance center to work. Doreen ruined that by running off, didn't she?
Oh, you can't blame her for doing that. I mean, we'd all like to get out of here.
Yeah, well, I know that, and I wouldn't mind if she had some sort of plan. Instead of running off on the spur of the moment like that, she'll end up back in here and all she'll get is a longer sentence.
She might make it.
Oh, how? She's got no plan and no one to help her.
Well, she's got Peter. I mean, he might know her somewhere.
That's right. He told me about another hideout. It's down by the...
Don't go telling everyone, Lizzie. Look, crackpots in here these days will do anything to get out. The screws are down 5 minutes flat.
Mail, Stokes.
Speaking of flat.
Birdsworth.
Oh, dear.
Adler. Dobbs. Here are Dobbs.
Anything for me?
No, why are you expecting something? Cavelli?
No.
Come on, ladies.
This is from America. Do you mind if I go and read it myself?
No, love, it's not much fun playing with just the two of us anyway.
What are you up to?
Nothing.
Well, if it's another harebrained scheme to escape, none of the other women better be involved.
Oh, don't worry yourself about that, B. None of the other women are involved in anything.
Hello, Lizzie.
Mrs. M.
Yes?
You got any news about Dor?
No, I haven't. But I have got some news about Peter. The police don't want him.
But what about that holder?
Well, they're convinced he wasn't involved. The only crime that he's committing is helping an escaped criminal. Now, if Doreen gave herself up, he'd be in the clear. It's a pity we don't know where she is, really. I mean, if we did, we could warn her.
But if she gave herself up, she'd still be charged with escaping, wouldn't she, Mrs. M?
You know the system as well as I do, Lizzie. The longer she's out, the worse the consequences will be. So it would help if she gave herself up. However, this is all pretty academic, really, when we don't even know where she is. I hope that's good news.
Well, Mrs. M.
Yes?
If you knew where Dor was, you would go to her, wouldn't you? And you'd tell her and you wouldn't send the cops after her.
Well, I'd have to check that the information was correct first. I mean, I wouldn't want to send the police on a wild goose chase, would I?
But you would tell her, and, you know, about Pete and all that.
Well, of course.
Well, she's hiding in a boathouse at Taylor's Bend.
Whereabouts at Taylor's Bend?
I don't know. But it's by the river.
I'm sure I'll find it. You did the right thing telling me, Lizzie.
You all right?
Yeah. You know, I reckon we're a bit stupid before thinking we'd get caught. We could stay on the run forever.
You reckon?
Oh, yeah. We could go interstate. Nobody'd have to know we were there. We could get a flat, jobs, everything. Be real nice to be living in the sun up in Queensland.
No, we wouldn't make it.
We won't if you don't think we can. We could do it. We're real smart. I mean, look at the way we got Martin into that hospital. There we were with a cop just a few feet away and we didn't get caught.
Yeah, I really thought he was going to grab us. When that nurse called out, I thought we were gone for sure.
Yeah, but that was real smart the way you thought up that idea of parking the car in the ambulance bay.
Oh, it just sort of came to my head. I mean, I had to say something.
Yeah, well, that was good, see, because that shows that you're quick and you can think when you're in trouble. And I've been on the run before. I know lots of tricks. We could hide up all day and travel at night.
Yeah, how will we eat?
Oh, that's easy.
Yeah, well, how come I'm so hungry?
All right, I'll go and get something for you now.
Where from?
Nearest house. I just go up to the front door, ring the bell, and if nobody answers, I go around and break in the back.
Yeah, but what if they do answer?
Well, I just say that I'm looking for Peter Martin, and they'll say I'm sorry he doesn't live here, and I say I'm sorry, and I'll try the next house. I'll be back soon.
No, listen, no, you've done everything for me. It's about time I did my bit. Snow, you wait here, I'll go and get some food.
Oh, what time is it?
You asked me that 5 minutes ago. And turn that thing off. There won't be any more news until 4 o'clock.
Well, there might be a news flash.
If there is, we'll hear it at 4 o'clock.
Well, they must have got our demand note by now.
Of course they did. You delivered it, didn't you?
Well, why hasn't there been anything on the radio?
Well, they'd have to check that the clothes and the hair were mine.
Oh, they've had plenty of time to do that.
Well, perhaps the department has put a media ban on the news.
You mean they're not taking us seriously?
Yes, of course they're taking you seriously. They probably don't want Andrea to know the news. They want to keep her in the dark.
Yeah. She's probably wondering what's going on by now.
Andrea knew about the kidnap scheme then, did she?
I told you, you talk too much. And so do you.
Oh, I'm hungry.
Yeah, well, so am I, and that's just bad luck because there's no food here.
Well, haven't you got any money?
Haven't you?
I spend all mine at the newsagents.
There's some money in my bag, if you want
it. We don't want your money. This isn't a robbery. We're not thieves.
Well, it's not stealing if she's giving it to us. Oh, this is hopeless. I'm starving. Nobody's taking any notice of us. Well, this isn't going to work.
It'll work, and I'll go and get you some food. On second thoughts, you better go. I don't trust you alone with her for too long. You better tie her up again if you're going out.
Hey, Colleen.
Mrs. Powell.
Are we going to get to see Dave over today or not?
Mrs. Davidson isn't available.
Oh, what?
She's worked a double shift, so she's home sleeping.
Well, when will she be back?
I don't know. Anyhow, you're wasting your time. Mr. Fletcher said the attendance centre's been scrapped, and that's that.
And what are you grinning at?
If I told you, you wouldn't understand.
Wouldn't understand what?
Nothing.
Wouldn't understand what? If you know something I don't, you had better tell me.
I don't know anything.
Then why are you grinning?
Because you couldn't see Dave.
Oh, that's funny, is it?
No.
Then you are pretty stupid, aren't you? Well, aren't you?
Sure.
All right, come on. Let's play cards. You too, Lizzie. The two things in this world I cannot stand. They are smart asses and laggers.
Sometimes you have to tell on people for their own good.
There is never a good excuse for lagging.
Your jacket. It's all right. I'm on my own. Peter, I've checked with the police. You're in the clear. Your friends didn't implicate you in the robbery. The only trouble you'll get into is by helping Doreen.
Hello, Mrs. Morris.
Doreen?
Peter's not here.
Well, where is he?
He's gone out to get some food. But is it like you just said, that the police don't really want him?
Yes. Now, if you give yourself up, he'll be in the clear. Well, that's why you escaped, isn't it? To help him.
Yeah. How do I know I can trust you? You lagged on him before. You called the police.
I didn't. The lady next door made a complaint about the attendance centre. And if you hadn't panicked, none of this would have happened. Doreen, if I was lying to you, I wouldn't be here now. The police would.
Well, how did you find me?
Lizzie told me. Well, she believes me. She wants to help. Oh, now give yourself up, Doreen.
I can't. Not until I've talked to Peter. He'll wonder where I am.
All right, then. We'll wait for him.
No. If he sees you here, he might make a run for it. Please leave me here and I'll talk to him.
The last time I trusted you, you ran out on me.
I won't this time, honest. I just want to talk to him on my own.
All right, then. But if you don't give yourself up by tomorrow, I'm afraid I'm going to have to tell the police where you're hiding and who with. And that'll implicate Peter, and then he'll be in serious trouble. Now, you do understand that, don't you?
Come on, Lizzie, up you get. Why, you were tossing and turning last night. I would have thought you'd be glad to get out of bed.
I couldn't sleep.
Yeah, you made sure I didn't. What's the matter? You scared of getting out of something?
No. I was thinking the door.
Yeah, well, there's nothing we can do for her in here.
Bea, you know what you said about hating laggers yesterday.
You know how I feel, Lizzie.
Yeah. Well, I told Mrs. M that I thought I knew where Dor was hiding.
You what?
She told me that the cops weren't after young Pete and that Dor would only be getting them into more trouble if they were on the run. And I thought I was doing the right thing.
Yeah, well, maybe you're right. As far as we know, Doreen isn't back inside. Maybe she wasn't hiding where you thought she was.
No.
Okay, after the showers. Is the only radio in here?
Yeah, well.
It's been confiscated.
What for?
I just carry out my orders.
Well, I want to see Mrs. Davidson.
I think I've already told you she isn't available.
You mean she's not coming in today either?
I have to confiscate the radios, that's all I know.
What's going on, Bea?
Oh, I don't know. Listen, maybe we'd better get in touch with Judy. She might be able to find out something in reception.
Yeah, and when we finish this, I'm going to get some more food. So easy breaking into that house.
You can't go breaking into the same house again.
No, I'll try another one.
Well, you can't even work the same street. I mean, too many break-ins in the one area and the cops get suspicious.
Yeah, you're right. How far away do you reckon I ought to try?
I reckon we ought to get out of here altogether and go interstate.
We're not going anywhere until Martin's out of hospital.
Well, at least we should move to somewhere else close by.
Martin gets over these asthma attacks pretty quickly. I mean, if they let him out and he comes here looking for us, he's going to be worried if we're not here.
If we stay here, we'll get caught.
Look, if you're so bloody worried, why don't you just go?
No.
Look, you're in enough trouble as it is for escaping. I mean, what's going to happen if they catch you with me? It's going to be even worse.
I'm not going to leave you, Peter. We're in this together.
I'm not going to leave you either. I better get on and get some more food, though.
Well, have you found out anything?
Well, they're pretty guarded about what they'll say in front of me. But as far as I can make out, Davo's gone missing.
Missing? You mean she shot through?
Oh, I think it'd have to be something more than that, love. Otherwise, they wouldn't have put it on the radio.
No, that wouldn't be enough reason to confiscate our stuff.
Well, the cops have been called in. Your son called Ross. I heard him say to Fletcher there was nothing new, but they thought it was time they interviewed Hennessey.
Oh, so she is involved. I thought so. Where is she now?
They're interviewing her now.
Well, scrounge around and see if you can find if anyone held onto a radio.
Okay.
Find that radio. What do the cops want?
Just having me, trying to find out who tried to bust me out.
And what did you tell them?
Well, nothing. Gee, I know how you hate laggers, Bea.
Don't get smart. I don't care what you kept from the cops, but if you said anything that affects any of us, you will be sorry.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Well, you will.
Where's Linda?
Getting some fags from the van. And don't let her hear you calling her that.
I'm surprised you two are friends.
Why?
Well, you're so different.
We've got the same ideas.
What ideas?
We both believe in personal freedom. We don't believe in a society that locks people up.
Well, you lock me up.
Well, that's different.
Why is it? People do things wrong by society. Society locks them up. I do something you don't like, so you lock me up. It's exactly the same. I've always thought it was rather inhuman to lock people up, but society hasn't come up with a viable alternative.
Well, there must be one.
Well, obviously you haven't found it. Otherwise, you wouldn't have taken such a violent course of action.
What's going on here?
We're just talking.
Well, don't. I don't want her putting any stupid ideas into your head.
Well, perhaps they aren't stupid.
Oh, shut up.
Oh, hey, you found one.
Yeah, from Deep Lock.
You tried any other stations?
The news will be on the minute.
Services today confirm that the parcel of clothes and hair delivered to Channel 10 last night
belongs
to Dr. Davidson, the governor of Westbrook Detention Center.
Shut up!
Contained a letter demanding a ransom and the release of a woman currently serving a 3-month sentence. The authorities have asked that the prisoner's name be withheld.
Well, no need to. We know who it is, don't we? Hennessey.
I thought all radios were supposed to be confiscated.
I must have missed one.
Oh, is it true that Mrs. Davidson's been kidnapped?
I'll have the radio, please.
Well, why keep it a secret from us?
I think the idea was to stop Hennessey finding out.
She knows.
Listen, if Erica doesn't come back, well, then who'll be governor, Fletch?
I don't think he'd want the job. In any case, the governor of Barnhurst would be next in line.
Oh. Oh. Vera?
Probably. Lizzie, can I see you for a moment?
Here you go.
I found Doreen, Lizzie.
She all right, Mrs. M?
Well, she was when I saw her. I gave her time to tell Peter he was in the clear and then give herself up.
She'll do the right thing, Mrs. M.
Well, she hasn't so far. Now, if she doesn't report in soon, I'm afraid I'll have to call the police.
Couldn't you give her a little more time?
I've already given her more than enough time, Lizzie. Now, I'm not breaking my word to you. I've stuck my neck out pretty far on this.
I understand, Mrs. M.
Whatever happens, Lizzie, you did the right thing in telling me.
I warned her. I told her if she did anything that affected the rest of us, she'd pay for it. Now, the point is, what do we do to her?
Well, what can we do about it? If they have taken Davidson outside as hostage, there's nothing we can do.
Look, you're awfully soft on Hennessey lately. Whose side are you on anyway?
I'm on your side, of course. All I'm saying is that there's nothing we can do.
We could always take our own hostage.
You mean Andrea?
That's a terrific idea. B, can I be in it?
No, you're not going to do anything to mess up your parole. Besides, your old heart wouldn't stand it.
Oh, I can take it.
No!
Well, at least I can steal the food and take the messages.
Oh, all right. It'll take two of us to handle Hennessey anyway. Are you in it? Okay, the first thing we do is get the women in D block to organise a bit of a fuss, you know, because their radios have been confiscated. Throw a few bits of furniture around, that sort of thing. We'll leave the screws occupied while we grab Hennessey. And then we're going to give her a dose of her own medicine.
Look at that scarf you're talking about, Jude.
Oh, yeah, I'll get it.
What's that?
Oh, it's from an D block. They're rioting because their radio was confiscated. Thought you'd approve of that. Individuals lashing out against authority.
Yeah, well, people can't let themselves be pushed around forever, B. They've got to act sometime, you know.
Now, that's what we thought. Ah! What? Oh! Oh! Keep still. Oh, I bet your mate's giving Dave a worse than this. Oh! Okay, check to see if it's all clear.
It's not me.
Quiet!
Hey, what's going on, Mrs. Powell?
As if you didn't know, Brian.
Good day, Mrs. Powell. Yes, I'm
going with some clean. It's okay. What's your
duty? That was all I could manage this time. I'll get you some later.
Oh, no one's going to be coming out of here for a while, Lizzie, thanks.
Look, what's going
Shut
on?
Up. Good for you.
Look, you can't keep me in here.
Oh, yeah? Do you know what I've been here for? I choked the woman to death, and I shot my husband at point-blank range. Double murder, so they're never going to let me out of here. I bet they're going to lose. Come on.
Come on, Lizzie, quick. We haven't got much time.
Yeah. Well, good luck.
Thanks for going me.
Okay, grab the other end of this bed. Up against the door. Round the door! That's right.
It's beating like a jitterbug.
Well, this doesn't work. Nothing will.
What are you looking for?
Oh, I was just keeping a watch out.
You know, nobody ever comes around here.
Somebody's sure to, sooner or later. If we don't get out of here, we're bound to get caught.
Look, I told you, we're not going until Martin's out of hospital.
Well, why don't you ring the hospital and find out how Martin is?
I did this morning. They said he was as well as could be expected.
Well, then?
Yeah, they always say that. I mean, if he was okay, they'd let him out, wouldn't they?
Yeah, but what if he doesn't get out? Or what if your mum and dad have rung up? He may not make it around here anyway.
I'm staying, that's it. Do what you like.
Well, somebody was here earlier on.
When?
While you're out getting the food. A couple of fishermen.
Well, did they see you?
Well, no, but they did see the empty bottles and the food lying around, and they knew somebody had been living here. They thought it was a Darrow.
Oh, that's all right, then.
But they could be back. I mean, they were fishing in the river. We've got to get away from here, somewhere safe. I know somewhere. We could phone the hospital from there. Or we could phone your mum and dad. They'd know how Martin is.
They wouldn't tell me nothing. They just dobbed me in.
I could phone them. I could say I was a friend of Martin's.
Yeah, okay. Jeez, I'd be in a real mess without you, Dor.
Yeah, but we'll be all right together.
Yeah, you bet. Come on.
Hey, Judy, you want
me? No, thanks.
What's going on? Smith, open up.
You're wasting your time. We're holding Hennessey and we've got a little message for her mates who have kidnapped Mrs. Davidson.
We can't send any messages. We don't even know where they are.
Just put it on the radio. If they're as publicity happy as this one, they'll be listening to every bit of news about themselves there is.
What's the message?
Tell them we're holding Hennessey hostage. We don't let her go until they let Mrs. Davidson go. Oh, and you can also tell them that whatever happens to Mrs. Davidson happens to Hennessey. So she'd better come back alive.
Shall we give her some?
No, she can wait till we're finished.
I'm not hungry.
Well, please yourself.
What's this stuff?
Instant soup.
It's not even cooked. Look, it's got bits floating around on the top.
Well, that's the way it's supposed to be.
Did you boil the water?
Of course I did.
Doesn't look like it.
Look, I'm fed up with your criticising. If you don't like it, why don't you do the cooking?
Looks like I'm going to have to. I might as well. I do everything else.
Well, you haven't done so marvellously so far, have you? Coming out here without any food, and we haven't got Andrea back.
We will. It'll be no thanks to you when we do. God, you're hopeless. You should go home and play with your dolls. What are you doing? Sit down.
No!
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun last night.
share.